Short-term memory loss, what it is, what causes it, and how to prevent it. Check this out. Hey guys, this is Ron White. Maybe you saw me on Stan Lee's Superhumans on the History Channel or the National Geographic show Brain Games. When I was training for the USA Memory Championship, and I'm a two-time USA Memory Champion, I would store information in my short-term and my long-term memory. What is short-term memory? Short-term memory is anything that's in your memory for just 15 to 30 seconds. If it makes it past that 30-second mark, it's considered to be long-term memory. Examples of short-term memory might be temporarily remembering or memorizing a phone number until you have a chance to write it down. You just say it over and over in your brain, 867-5309, and until you have a chance to write it down. Another example of short-term memory is when you're having a conversation with someone and you think of something that you want to say and you hold that in your short-term memory until you are able to fit it into the conversation. A 50-year-old study suggests that the brain can hold, on average, 7 pieces of information in the short-term memory. More recent and modern studies, though, suggest that this number is closer to 4 pieces of information. Now, a lot of people may get panicked because they have short-term memory loss, but here are some examples of short-term memory loss that are absolutely normal and nothing to worry about. Misplacing common objects like your keys, totally normal. Another example would be not being able to think of the right word, totally normal. Not being able to remember what you just read or walking into a room and not remembering why you were there are also examples of normal short-term memory loss. Even occasionally calling someone by the wrong name is nothing to really be that worried about. But there are some signs that your memory may be in more serious trouble, and those would include getting seriously lost when you're driving home and you're really close to home, or having a hard time following very simple movie or book plot. Another example of what may be serious short-term memory loss would be something like not being able to remember if you've eaten yet today. Repeatedly asking the same question over and over again, or even personality changes, are more examples of more serious short-term memory loss. So that's what short-term memory loss is. Now, what causes short-term memory loss? Sleep apnea is a sleeping disorder where breathing temporarily stops briefly, but frequently during the night. You may have sleep apnea if you wake up with a headache, or you have daytime fatigue, or people complain about you snoring. These are signs of sleep apnea. One reason sleep apnea affects the memory is because during the night, your brain is briefly deprived of oxygen, and this is going to impact your brain and memory. The type of memory that sleep apnea is going to affect is remembering where you put your keys or trying to remember directions. Another thing that can cause short-term memory loss is a silent stroke. These silent strokes really affect the smaller blood vessels, and in doing that, it's going to affect the amount of oxygen that gets to your brain, and it's going to affect your short-term memory. The third thing that can impact your short-term memory is medications. When I was training and preparing for the USA Memory Championship, I would not take anything like a Tylenol PM or an Advil PM in the weeks or months prior to the tournament because I knew that would cloud my head and affect my short-term memory. Some examples of medications that can really affect your short-term memory are sleeping aids, antihistamines, anti-anxiety medications, painkillers, and even diabetes medication can impact your short-term memory. Number 4, the next thing that can lead to short-term memory loss is a nutritional deficiency, or specifically a lack of B12. A lack of B12 can lead to confusion and even dementia. And number 5, stress, anxiety, and depression can also lead to short-term memory loss. Prolonged stress will lead to depression, and this is really going to impact your ability to remember and function. Think about it. Was there a time in your life when you were really, really stressed? Your memory was probably also really poor during that time. So that's what short-term memory is and what can cause it. Now here's some steps to help you prevent short-term memory loss. The first step is getting a good night's sleep. Studies will suggest 8 hours of sleep is really the optimal amount of sleep that's going to support healthy, normal brain function the next day. Number two, a good way to combat short-term memory loss is through exercise. Now remember that stress, anxiety, and depression can lead to short-term memory loss. One of the best natural cures to combat stress, anxiety, and depression is exercise. It's also going to get that blood flowing, and that increased blood flow is more oxygen to your brain, and your memory is going to thank you for that. Next, avoid unnecessary medications. In other words, if you are taking pills to sleep, it's much better to go to sleep because you're exhausted from a good workout or a long day than it is to take medications to help you sleep, because that's might cloud your head the next day. So specifically, maybe some supplements that have B12 in them, but just make sure that you're getting all your essential vitamins and nutrients, because that's going to really help your memory. Don't smoke. Tobacco is going to kill your memory. It's terrible for your brain. It's terrible for your body. It's terrible for your memory. Avoid smoking. If you haven't started, don't start. Studies show that men who are heavy drinkers will experience mental decline on average 6 years earlier than those who are light drinkers. So take it easy on the bottle. All right, guys, studies will tell us that the average person can hold 4 to 7 pieces in their short-term memory. I have a technique known as the Mind Palace that will allow me to hold literally hundreds of pieces of information in my short-term memory. The Mind Palace is my favorite memory training technique. I have a free training for you on that, and I show you exactly how to build it the right way and avoid all the common mistakes. So get the training right here on how to build the Mind Palace the right way, or click the link right here for my free gift to help your short-term memory. Think of what I'm saying, and you say short-term memory loss.
Yeah.
You want to do that?
Yeah.
Or okay, so maybe you want to help your short-term memory.
That's perfect.
Yeah. Okay.